Hello, everyone. I'm your host, Shamis Ali, and you're watching Urban Legacy TV. Sitting next to me, I have the lovely Erica
Eichelkraut.
There we go. And she is the owner and editor of Nomad Magazine. It's a wonderful magazine. And as you described it, it's like a portable gallery. It's very beautiful. Tell everybody how you got started, Erica.
Actually, I just started to do it as a fun personal project. I had been living in Miami and came back just to escape the summer heat for a couple months, and that was last summer, and I haven't left yet. As soon as I hit back in Buffalo, there was such a vibe, such an energy. The creative life was just bursting here. Started seeing and meeting all these amazing artists and writers, and I wanted to do something to put those together. So initially, I was going to make maybe 50 copies just for fun, a really small 8-page little booklet about the art scene in Buffalo. And it turned in, it kind of snowballed into this bigger thing where businesses wanted to be involved, people wanted to help me pay for it. Tons of artists sent in work, writers, everybody just kind of came together. It seemed like there was a real need and a want for something like this in Buffalo. So, the name Nomad just strictly means it came from being a portable gallery. I wanted work that was put together that can be packaged and distributed. I wanted art that was accessible. I wanted art that could be brought into areas like the West Side, where people aren't going to the Albright Knox every Friday. And I wanted to bring it around and show off these artists and provide them a free arena to share their work and to bring it to new people, new audiences.
Okay, so basically, you were sitting somewhere one of these days, and you said to yourself, you know, I want to create a platform for people who are talented, mm-hmm. people who can write, people who can draw, people who have expression. Let them find a place to express themselves. So basically, this is what Nomad does. It allows freedom of expression.
Yeah, it actually started one night when I was at a coffee shop reading The Art Voice, and I was seeing all the listings of the writers' groups getting together, the artist groups, all the great shows going on around town, and I guess I just wanted something to kind of draw those lines together. And it's not there yet, but it's a start. It's portable, it's packageable, and it's a great way to put together all the local work and keep up with what's happening new and in Buffalo. Mm-hmm. Nomad, you know, Webster definition, people who follow a herd of Buffalo, where Buffalo goes. So as Buffalo grows, as the art scene changes, Nomad will bring the new work out and present that.
Now, this is a beautiful magazine. For this to be your first magazine, it's absolutely immaculate. So my question becomes, I like to talk about the struggle that comes with the beauty.
Yeah.
So talk a little bit about the bruises that came with this beautiful magazine.
Like I said, I initially was just going to do an 8-page thing, and I thought all that would entail would mean taking some work, laying it out, and sending it to print. But it overnight just blew up into this huge thing. I had to get a website up, do a call for submissions, start editing the work, contact all the artists, get permissions, put it all together in the layout. And, you know, then of course was the business side of things, was deciding to go forward with more copies. We ran 750 copies. It's a 24-page magazine, so significantly more than what I had initially anticipated. And then with that came the cost of the printing, so starting with ad sales and deciding, well, how much do I charge for this, and putting it all together. And I worked out a way so that, you know, I didn't make a dollar off of it. It was a completely volunteer project. And the businesses that gave money essentially were purchasing copies of the magazine to be distributed around Buffalo. It wasn't just an ad sale. Yes, they were getting an ad in the back, but they're supporting this. There's over 45 writers and artists in the magazine, so they're supporting them. We did a really nice thing too, where we have a donated ad page where local non-for-profit charities could put in an ad for free. So businesses who purchase ads were also supporting that cause as well. So it's just a really cool way to bring resources and talents and money together to produce something that is a joint effort and a collaborative kind of project. And I was just kind of the orchestrator on that. But, you know, it wouldn't be anything without the money from the sponsors, and then all the amazing pieces from all the artists and writers involved.
So if someone's watching right now, they say, hey, Nomad Magazine, that sounds like my format. What type of concepts do you accept? What are the submissions? You know, what are they like?
Right now, we're, you know, obviously a print publication. So any 2D artwork, photographs and sculptures, definitely writing, short stories, poetry and prose. I want to get to a point where I can grow the website to host music and film and video artwork and animations. You know, if there's any amazing web developers that want to help me out there, that would be cool. But right now it's just a print publication. There's no guidelines as far as the theme of the work. But all the submission information is on the website, nomadbuffalo.com. And we have all the details on there. It's really easy, pretty easy going. And right now we have submissions open for our fall issue closing August 15th.
Same for the ad sales.
Is this a quarterly or is this monthly, weekly? What?
Quarterly. Call it seasonally. So that's our summer issue. And then we have a fall one coming out in September. You know, I was just going to do one, but the feedback has been outstanding and already submissions are pouring in. So, and ad sales are taking off. So there's really no reason not to keep it going. So,
wow. Well, God bless you in this endeavor, girl. Good job. So tell the viewers one more time if they're interested in sending in some work or they just want to sponsor the magazine or if they just want to donate or want to be a part of, because as we were talking prior to the interview, you said that Stillwaters, you were having some local events coming up at Stillwaters. Talk a little bit about that.
We had our release party for the magazine on the 14th, and it was just overwhelming how many people showed up. It was amazing to see the support. And we had an open mic, and the performers were incredible. We need speakers, we need poets, we need musicians, hip-hop artists, acoustic, anything you want to bring to the table, we want to support a format for that. And the guys from Free Henry, which is an amazing local band, they're actually playing at the Square coming up, got a lot of cool stuff coming on. They contacted me and asked if I wanted to collaborate on a project. So what we've started is called Wham, which is a writers, artists, and musicians monthly mixer mingler, and it's going to be hosted at Stillwater. We're going to do it one Wednesday a month. We have our first one coming up June 10th, so a week from today. And
June 10th, don't do anything that evening, June 10th.
Come to Stillwater, we'll have drink specials, music, open mic, we're going to have art projects going. It's just a great way, if you have any interest in any of this, just to come and learn a little bit more about it and to meet people and say hello and make your presence known in the arts community, because Buffalo's got it and we just need to grow it and we need people who believe in it to carry it forward and onward. And it's such a city for young, self-starting people, and it's, you know, it may not have everything, but it certainly has places to start things and bring it to the table. So anyway, Stillwater, June 10th, 7 to 10. Come. You can see more information on nomadbuffalo.com. And I look forward to submissions and ad sales and supports. And unfortunately, 750 copies are gone. They were gone within a day or two. So I'm going to be doing reorders. They are available for purchase on the website. We were able to give away for free 750. So if you want to come on the website and pick up a copy, do that. Otherwise, see you in September.
So the only way they can really get in touch with Nomad is basically through the website, pretty much.
They can email me at nomadbuffalo@gmail.com.
And we'll put that information up in case you want to get in contact with Erica. We'll put that information up for you. And also, again, nomadbuffalo.com.
Easy enough.
Okay, Erica, it was such a pleasure meeting with you. You're such a wonderful young lady. She's doing big things, so you want to stay on top of Mrs. Erica here. So we're closing out, and I am your host, Shamise Ali, on Urban Legacy TV. See you soon.